Bittersweet Symphony is a song by the British band The Birth, produced and released in 1997. The song starts with a long intro that was a big problem for the band because they took this riff from the beginning of the song from an old Rolling Stone song. This led to a lot of problems. Eventually, The Birth lost the rights to their song. So after this long intro, the lyrics of the story begin like this. Because it's a bittersweet symphony, this life. Try to make ends meet, you're a slave to money, then you die. He starts by saying, because it's a bittersweet symphony, this life. When something is bittersweet, you say that at the same time, it's good and bad. It makes you feel good and it makes you feel bad. So here, for the writer, for the singer of this song, life is a symphony that is bitter and sweet, that it's good and bad at the same time. Why? He says, try to make ends meet. Try to make ends meet. That's actually an expression we explained in one of our videos. Where is it? Here. So you can check that expression, but it's about money. It's about earning money. And right after, he says, you're a slave to money, then you die. So you live all your life trying to make more money, to earn money. You become a slave to money, and then you die. And then he says, I'll take you down the only road I've ever been down. You know, the one that takes you to the places where all the veins meet. Yeah. He says, I'll take you down the road, the only road I've ever been down. In this case, when you say that you will take a person, a road down, this means you are going to show them, you are going to lead them, to guide them to not necessarily a road, but a way, a path of something. So he's basically saying, I am going to show you the only thing I know. I'll take you down the only road I've ever been down. I'm going to show you what I know. You know, the place, the road that takes you to the places where all the veins meet. So I am going to take you, I am going to take you to this road that takes you to the places where all the veins meet. What are veins? The veins are these little vessels in your body that carry blood. So when people try to commit suicide, they cut off their veins. So the blood starts coming out and eventually they die. These are the veins. So what is the meaning of this part of the story? The one that takes you to the places where all the veins meet. For a lot of people, this is a reference to drugs, to use drugs and inject drugs into your veins. So he's saying, I am going to take you to the place where you can be free because all the veins meet, because we are using drugs. And then he says, no change, I can change, I can change, I can change, but I'm here in my mold, I am here in my mold. No change, I can change, I can change, I can change, but I am here in my mold, I am here in my mold. So first he says no change, so there is no change, everything remains the same, everything is the same, but he says, I can change. I can change. I have the possibility to change, to stop doing these things I don't like and change. But I am here in my mold. I am here in my mold. What is a mold? A mold is usually something that you use to shape things, to change the form or the shape of things. Think of Jell-O or cookies. When you make cookies, you prepare the cookie dough and then you put it to bake. But you want your cookies to have a shape, a star or a circle or whatever. So you put the mixture into molds and then the cookies take the form of the mold. Here he's saying, I am here in my mold. I have a mold. I have this, perhaps this body that contains what I am. I am here in my mold. I can change, but I am here in my mold. And then he says, but I am a million different people from one day to the next. I can't change my mold. No, 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 no. So he says, I am a million different people from one day to the next. So he is trying to fight maybe the establishment, the idea that you have to be something. So when he wants to fit, when he wants to be a part of the world or the society, he's changing. He's different people. Today he's one kind of person. Tomorrow he's a different. The day after tomorrow he's going to be a different person. He is a million different people and he can change his mold. It's not possible for him to change his mold. He is what it is. And then he says, well, I never pray, but tonight I'm on my knees. Yeah, I need to hear some sounds that recognize the pain in me. So he starts saying, well, I never pray, so I am not a religious person. I don't talk to God. I never pray, but tonight I'm on my knees. So he usually doesn't pray, but maybe tonight he is. Maybe he's desperate. It's a cry for help. It's doing something that he usually doesn't, and now he is on his knees praying. He says, I need to hear some sounds that recognize the pain in me. So I am in pain. I am feeling pain, and I want some empathy. I want to hear sounds, maybe he means voices, that recognize the pain in me. I need someone who understands how I feel, who understands my pain. And then he goes on to say, I let the melody shine. I let it cleanse my mind. I feel free now. But the airways are clean and there is nobody singing to me now. So he says, I let the melody shine. So the melody is maybe the voices he wants to hear. So I let it shine. I am not interfering with it. I let it shine. I let it cleanse my mind. Cleanse my mind. So I let it get into my mind and remove all the toxic things, all the bad things. I let it cleanse my mind. I feel free now because now I am letting the melody shine. I am maybe accepting help. But the airways are clear, so now the space is clear because I stopped being an obstacle. I am open to that. And there is nobody singing to me. So now that I am crying for help, I am saying, I am here. I want someone to recognize the pain in me. I want someone to acknowledge the way I feel. There is nobody singing to me. The rest of the story is a progression of these same lines. No change. I can change. I can change. I can change. But I am here in my mold. I am here in my mold. So he is finally saying that he wants to change and he can change. It's possible for him to change, but because of this mold, because of these limits that society or people have placed on him, he is not really free. In a couple of verses later, he takes the same verses we checked. He only makes little changes, but the story remains the same. A Bittersweet Symphony is the story of a guy who sees life like that. There are no absolutes. Life is not completely good nor completely bad. And he sees both sides, the bitter side, the bad side, and the sweet side. And he is complaining about the rules of society, the power of money. He is asking for help. And finally, when he does it, nobody is responding to it. So that's the story of this song. It's maybe a very realistic view of life, maybe for some people a pessimistic view of life, but that's the way he, the guy who wrote the song, was feeling. A cry for help, an explanation of how life makes you into something, gives you a mold, and you can't get out of it. So I hope you enjoyed this explanation. I hope it was clear and you can use the song now to learn all of the things we explained today and also to keep listening to the song and keep learning seamlessly, naturally. If you have a song you want me to inspect, let me know down here in the comments or on Facebook or on Twitter, and we will try to make the songs you ask as soon as we can. Remember that if you want to help us make more videos, we have a lot of ideas, but we need your support to put all these ideas into projects and make them a reality. If you want to help us, you can do that by following the link down here in the description or the link right here. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much for your support, and I will see you next week for a new video. Thank you very much and keep it simple.